Verified. Ready to roll.
Hello, my name's Eric, and today I'm going to show you how to perform a transmission flush on a 2005 Hyundai Elantra. The first thing I need to do is get my machine hooked up to the battery. So to do so, I'm going to have to hook up to the positive and negative terminals. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hook up to the transmission cooler line on top of the transmission, so I'm going to have to disconnect the line. So after you've got your transmission fittings from your transmission machine hooked up to the transmission cooler lines, you need to start up the vehicle, and in this case, this vehicle needs to be flushed in neutral. So we're going to start up the vehicle and flush the transmission in neutral. What I'm going to do is I'm going to flush 12 quarts through this system because that's 3 times the amount of the fluid capacity that the transmission actually takes. And basically, the reason that the machine flushes 3 times the amount of the capacity that the transmission takes is just so that it ensures that it gets all of the fluid out of all of the components of the transmission, the torque converter, the pump, and all of the lines. It gets everything out of there. It's 100% fluid exchange. Basically, on this machine, it has the lines that actually hook up to your transmission cooler lines, which are these guys right here. There's the gauge cluster, which shows you how to take out or add fluid a half pint at a time. There's different fluid capacities of flushing for different styles of transmissions. It shows you the new side, the fluid that it's going to put in there, and it's showing the fluid that it takes out also. Transmissions in most vehicles generally need to be flushed out every 2 to 3 years or every 30 to 50,000 miles. You do this so that you get all of the contaminants and metal particles out of the fluid that's in there already. In this case, our machine only exchanges the fluid. On most vehicles, there is also an internal filter inside of the transmission pan that needs to be dropped, and the filter needs to be changed as well. The filters are supposed to be changed out about every 50 to 75,000 miles. In this case, the filter has just recently been changed, so we're just going to flush the fluid. And then what I'm going to do now is go inside of the vehicle, and I'm going to run the transmission through the gears and then put it back in neutral and come and check the level of the fluid. All right, I've run the transmission gears through and put it back in neutral, and now I'm going to check the level of the fluid to see where we're at. All right, and after checking this, the level of the transmission is halfway up the cold mark on the dipstick. Which is perfect because I need to leave a little room to put my UTP additive in there so that it meets specifications for the fluid for this transmission for this vehicle. And now I'm going to disconnect the transmission lines from the machine, and then I'm just going to hook the transmission lines back up so that I can restart the vehicle and recheck the level of the fluid and add my UTP additive. All right, now we've got our transmission cooler line hooked back up properly, so what I'm going to do now is add my UTP additive. UTP is a universal transmission protectant additive, which basically can be added to Dextron 3 to meet specifications for most fluid types and transmissions. All right, I've added my UTP through the transmission dipstick tube. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to start the vehicle back up, run it through the gears, put it back in neutral, and check the level of the fluid. I'm also at this time going to be coming to check the lines for any leaks. All right, perfect. Once you have the fluid to the top of the cold line on the bottom of the transmission dipstick, that's right where you want to be, because when this fluid heats up, it expands. So then it'll bring it into the full operating level in the hot mark on the transmission dipstick. And after you're done flushing, it's good to just make sure, double check everything, make sure that there's no leaks on the system, and that everything is nice and cleaned up. And that was our transmission flush that I've showed you how to do today.